Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Almighty God, to whom all hearts are open, all desires known, and from whom no secrets are hidden, cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord. Amen. Lord Jesus, you said to your disciples, "You have not chosen me, but I have chosen you." Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, we know that the harvest is plentiful, but the labourers are few. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you appointed us to go and bear fruit that will last. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty and everlasting God, by whose Spirit the whole body of the Church is governed and sanctified, hear our prayer, which we offer for your faithful people, that in their vocation and ministry they may serve you in holiness and truth, to the glory of your name. Through our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and for ever.
Amen.
A reading from the book Ecclesiasticus. The Lord created human beings out of earth and makes them return to it again. He gave them a fixed number of days, but granted them authority over everything on the earth. He endowed them with strength like his own and made them in his own image. He put the fear of them in all living beings and gave them dominion over beasts and birds. Discretion and tongue and eyes, ears and a mind for thinking he gave them. He filled them with knowledge and understanding and showed them good and evil. He put the fear of him into their hearts to show them the majesty of his works. And they will praise his holy name to proclaim the grandeur of his works. He bestowed knowledge upon them and allotted to them the law of life. He established with them an eternal covenant and revealed to them his decrees. Their eyes saw his glorious majesty, and their ears heard the glory of his voice. He said to them, "Beware of all evil." And he gave commandment to each of them concerning a neighbour. Their ways are always known to him. They will not be hid from his eyes. The response to Psalm 103. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Bless the Lord, O my soul. As a father has compassion on his children, so is the Lord merciful towards those who fear him. For he knows of what we are made, he remembers that we are but dust. Bless the Lord, O my soul. Our days but as grass, we flourish as a flower of the field. For as soon as the wind goes over it, it is gone, and its place shall know it no more. Bless the Lord, O my soul. But the merciful goodness of the Lord is from of old, and endures for ever on those who fear him, and his righteousness on children's children, on those who keep his covenant, and remember his commandments to do them. Bless the Lord, O my soul.
Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory. Praise to you, O Christ, King of eternal glory.
The Lord is a great God. Oh, that today you would listen to his voice. Harden not your hearts. Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, O Lord.
People were bringing little children to Jesus in order that he might touch them, and the disciples spoke sternly to them. But when Jesus saw this, he was indignant and said to them, "Let the little children come to me. Do not stop them, for it is to such as these that the kingdom of God belongs. Truly, I tell you, whoever does not receive the kingdom of God as a little child will never enter it." And he took them up in his arms, laid his hands on them, and blessed them. This is the gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
Today is an Ember Day. It is also the day upon which the church celebrates the ministry of George Herbert, who wrote that marvellous Lenten poem, "What is the Fast?" The fast is to spring clean our hearts, to empty the larder of our hearts of pride and anger and malice. I can't remember it off the top of my head, but it's well worth looking up. Lent is called. We're praying today for the Embertide because we're remembering the ministry of the people of God. Ministry just means work. Work can often, people assume that Christian ministry is associated with the smell of incense. I would suggest it's also associated with the smell of bleach and with all of those other smells that the people of God, whether they're working in hospital or whether they're working in school or whether they're working in a hospital, are all of them offering up a sweet smelling savour to the Lord, a sweet smelling sacrifice to God. We pray especially today for the ordinands here at St George's, for those who are seeking a licensed ministry, it's called in the Church of England. Natasha, Alvaro, Stefan, Yvonique and Carol, who are training as lay readers. Also a guy called Nicolas Boisson, who is in that eternal merry-go-round of life. He's a Frenchman who's actually wanting to live in the UK. He seems to have been caught up on the horns of Brexit and something about his status and how the Church of England is going to process him. So he's going through a particularly anxious time at the moment. He started working in the church in Wales and then COVID hit and the money ran out, so he had to move to London. The poor man has really been through it. If we could all, if I could also ask you to remember in your prayers Mircea Silaji, who is an archpriest in Timișoara in Romania. Mircea and I have known one another for a number of years. He is now a fine priest. Please pray for him and his family. In the Romanian church, you have not just theological studies for priests, but you also have a school for priests' wives as well. And they're called presbyteras. That's actually the sort of honorific title. And when I was there, Mircea stood on one side, I was there for the Assumption, and there was this new hymn we were singing. It was only about 150 years old, which in Orthodox terms is new. Anyway, so he stood on one side of the church and led the men singing, and she stood on the other side of the church and led the women singing. Oh boy, did this hymn go on for a long time. Anyway, that's the point. Ministry is about all of us doing what God has called us to do. So we pray for the flourishing of God's gifts to his church. Jesus, Lord of your church. So we say together, Jesus, Lord of your church, in your mercy hear us. Jesus, Lord of your church, in your mercy hear us. God our Father, you give us gifts that we may work together in the service of your Son. Bless the leaders of your church. Especially we pray for Bishop Robert and Bishop David. We pray for the priests in Cologne, Father Douglas and Father Peter. We pray for Father Nicholas here in firm in faith and humble before you. Jesus, Lord of your church, in your mercy, hear us. Bless those who teach, especially those who teach, who are teaching young people online at the moment. We pray for patience, for courage, for energy, and for a sense of your presence, that they may increase our understanding and be open to your word for them. Jesus, Lord of your church, in your mercy, hear us. Bless those who minister healing, especially for those in our health services, for doctors and nurses experience exhaustion, trauma and stress because of COVID, that they may bring wholeness to others. We pray that they may yet know your healing in themselves. Jesus, Lord of your church, in your mercy, hear us. Bless those who work in your world today, that in the complexity of their daily lives, they may live for you, fulfill your purposes, and seek your kingdom first. We bring to mind those we work with, Lord. Jesus, Lord of your church, in your mercy, hear us. Bless those who are uncertain of their gifts and those who are powerless in this world's eyes, that they may be made strong in your gift of the Holy Spirit. We pray especially for the young people here at St. George's. We pray for the little children. We pray too for those who feel defeated by technology, those who are scared to go outside. Jesus, Lord of your church, in your mercy, hear us. In a moment's quiet now, we pray for all those who we carry in our hearts and minds. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. We are all one in Christ Jesus. We belong to him through faith, heirs of the promise of the Spirit of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have this bread to offer, which earth has given and human hands have made. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation. For your goodness we have this wine to offer, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Heavenly Father, as we set before you these gifts of bread and wine, bless also the gift of our hearts and minds as we offer you our lives in your service through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give thanks and praise.
It is indeed right and good, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Through your servant Jesus Christ, our Lord. At his baptism he was revealed as your beloved Son, and coming among us as one who serves, he taught that they are greatest in your kingdom who make themselves least and the servants of all. Although he was their teacher and their Lord, he washed the feet of his disciples and commanded us to do the same. Through your Holy Spirit, you bestow upon your people a rich diversity of gifts and ministries, and from this royal priesthood you raise up men and women to proclaim your word, to care for your people, and to be the stewards of the mysteries of Christ. You call them to serve the world your Son redeemed, and build up his body, the Church, to the greater glory of your name. And so, with angels and archangels and all the heavenly host, we proclaim your glory and join their unending hymn of praise. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. All glory be to you, our heavenly Father, who in your tender mercy gave your only Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ, to suffer death upon the cross for our redemption, who made there by his one oblation of himself once offered a full, perfect, and sufficient sacrifice, oblation, and satisfaction for the sins of the whole world. He instituted and, in his holy gospel, commanded us to continue a perpetual memory of his precious death until he comes again. Hear us, merciful Father, we humbly pray, and grant that, by the power of your Holy Spirit, we, receiving these gifts of your creation, this bread and this wine, according to your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ's holy institution, in remembrance of his death and passion, may be partakers of his most blessed body and blood. Who in the same night that he was betrayed took bread and gave you thanks, he broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take, eat, this is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." In the same way, after supper, he took the cup and gave you thanks. He gave it to them, saying, "Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it, in remembrance of me." Praise to you, Lord Jesus. Dying, you destroyed our death. Rising, you restored our life. Lord Jesus, come in glory. Therefore, Lord and Heavenly Father, in remembrance of the precious death and passion, the mighty resurrection and glorious ascension of your dear Son, Jesus Christ, we offer you through him this our sacrifice of praise and thanksgiving. Grant that by his merits and death and through faith in his blood, we and all your Church may receive forgiveness of our sins and all other benefits of his passion. Although we are unworthy through our manifold sins to offer you any sacrifice, yet we pray that you will accept this, the duty and service that we owe. Do not weigh our merits, but pardon our offences, and fill us all who share in this holy communion with your grace and heavenly blessing. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord, by whom and with whom and in whom, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all honour and glory be yours, Almighty Father, for ever and ever.
Amen.
Led by the Spirit, let us pray as our Saviour taught us, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are many, we are one body, because we all share in one bread. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those who are called to his supper. Lord, I am not worthy to receive you, but only say the word, and I shall be healed. this harvest, Lord of the harvest, you have fed your people in this sacrament with the fruits of creation made holy by your Spirit. By your grace, raise up among us faithful labourers to sow your word and reap the harvest of souls through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
May the boldness of the Spirit transform you. May the gentleness of the Spirit lead you. May the gifts of the Spirit equip you to serve and worship God. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with you and remain with you this day and always. Amen. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. In the name of